Hello and welcome. In this tutorial, I will demonstrate how to do a feasibility study, including massing and statistics in Revit using Planary 2. We're going to start with a basic sketch and drawing our building and our site using fill regions. Every fill region represents a building part. We have the ground level, which is going to be a retail and residential. We have a podium and we have a tower. Next, we are going to the Adding tab and open Planary. I'm going to drag Planary to the side and split my screen that I can see and work on both, my Revit view and Planary. To add our first site, I will right-click on the Planary browser, select Add Site, and pick a property line or a fill region from the Revit view. When clicking on the site from the 3D view or from the browser, under Properties, I can rename my site and give more information, such as zoning and ownership. I can also see my site area. To create our building, I will right-click on the site and select Add Building. The next step will be creating building parts using the fill regions from the Revit. I will right-click on the building, select Add Building Part, and pick a fill region from my Revit view. So we have our first building part. This one is gonna be our retail. I'm gonna change the floor levels, floor height, and I also have the option to make it an underground. I'm gonna leave it unchecked, and I'm gonna select the use, the building section, and in our case, we don't have any residential units, so I'm gonna uncheck. And we have our first building part. To add more building parts, I'm gonna right-click on our building part and select building part on level, go back to my Revit view and pick the next fill region. As you can see, it showed immediately in the 3D view. I'm gonna select this building part and under properties, I'm gonna rename it and I can change parameters. Now we're gonna add our podium. I'm gonna right click on residential and pick add building part above. I'm gonna go back to my Revit view and pick the podium fill region. And I'm gonna do the same, gonna rename it. And also give it number of floors, floor height, use and building section, which is gonna be podium. And on top of the podium, we have the tower. I will right click on the podium, select add building part above, go back to Revit view and pick the tower fill region. Let's rename it and I'll call it a tower. Give it a number of floors. Under building section, it will be a tower. So we have a first building. As you can see on the analysis tab, we're starting to get information. We have the TFA, the GFA areas, we have the site area, we have the FSI, we have the total height, the number of stories. We also have a unit count, parking, and we have our unit mix. The cool thing is that we can always go to our fill region, adjust, change and edit, and the statistics will change simultaneously. At any time, I can unlink the element from the fill region. I'll right click on the element and select unlink. I can pick a different fill region by right clicking again and selecting link. In Planary, we can also add land and land use. To add land, we can right click on the site and instead of selecting a building, I'm gonna select land. Other properties, I can give it a name, thickness, and use. Next to the analysis tab, we can find the area distribution tab. Here we can see the building area distribution and the land use, by percentage and by area. So what we have so far, we have one site with one building. The building have ground level retail and also residential. And on top we have a podium. And on top of the podium, we have a tower. In Planary, we also have the option to set a location and to place our site in the city context. To do that, go to Options and enable City Context. On the Map Properties, I can type the address or use geolocation. With the Place Marker on Map, I will select the point to place my site. With the Change Site Base Point, I can create a base point in my Revit view to link to the Planary map. I'm gonna go to my Revit view and pick a point. I can use the rotation tool and change the marker location at any time. I can also place a 2D map in my Revit view by simply clicking on Place 2D Map. And here we have a 2D satellite view in Revit to indicate the site location. Under Style, I can turn on the satellite map, the street names, and the location marker. I can hide existing buildings from the 3D map by clicking on the pencil and selecting the buildings from the view. In Planary, we can add more sites and more buildings. I'm gonna right click on Planary Browser and add two more sites. I'm gonna create a building for each site by right clicking and picking fill regions from my Revit view. So here we have three sites. On each site we have one building. In Planary we also have the option to have an angular plane. To create an angular plane, we're gonna first draw a detail line in the Revit view. I'm gonna right click on my site and select Add Angular Plane. I'm gonna go back to my Revit view and pick my detail line. So as you can see, we have an angular plane. I can move it and drag it around. When clicking on the angular plane, under Properties, I can give it a name, an angle, and also offset from the ground. On the browser, next to each building, site, or land, we have a checkbox. That way, by checking or unchecking, we can exclude or include our buildings or our sites from the total calculation and when we export the data and masses. Under Option Preferences, we can customize our project parameters. We can change the efficiency for the GFA, the cell efficiency, the project units, the parking space ratio by area and by residential units. We can also customize our building spaces, building section, land use. We can rename or create a new building spaces, assign colors, or delete by clicking the garbage bin. Same thing with the building section and the land use. In the unit mix tab, I can create residential unit type and give it an average size and percentage. In Planary, we can also create an underground parking. In the Revit view, I created the fill region for the parking. In Planary, I will right-click on the building, create a building part, and pick the fill region. And this time, under Properties, I'm gonna check Underground. As you can see, this building part flipped and now it's underground. This one gonna be 2 floors. And under use, I'm gonna select parking. And on building section, this will be underground. Planary allows me to export the massing and also to export the statistics. To export a mass into Revit, we go to File, Export, and choose Mass into Revit. We're gonna name the massing and select the corresponding level. Planary will generate a Revit mass immediately and place it on the exact location of the fill regions. To export data to Excel, we go to File, Export, Excel data file, and save. Planary will create an Excel sheet of a project, summarize the statistics, give us a breakdown of our sites and our buildings. If you need any help or support, you are more than welcome to visit our website. Thank you.